Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Regular viewers will know by now I review many photographic, audio and video related products. And I will change that, honestly, I will. But for now, that's what we do here. And today, we're taking a look at a Panasonic lens. And it's a Panasonic 42.5mm lens designed for the Micro Four Thirds system. Now, with Panasonic, it gets a bit confusing because they're in two camps. They're in the Micro Four Thirds camps, such as the G9 I've got here, the GH5, the GH4, oh, there's loads of them, absolutely loads of them. And then they've got the full frame bodies. Well, this particular lens is designed for the Micro Four Thirds bodies. So it'll fit Olympus cameras and Panasonic Micro Four Thirds bodies. And I've actually got it fitted here to my Panasonic G9. And it is a very tiny lens. It's actually a 42.5mm on the G9, as it would be on the Olympus bodies, but that equates to 85mm in full frame terms. So it's a portrait lens, effectively. It's a compact, tiny little portrait lens. And there it is. Very, very, very tiny. And very light. I mean, it's a great lens. Metal construction, a metal mount, so you know it's not going to wear out very easily. The weight of it is really light. You wouldn't even know you've got that in your kit bag. It is that light. Let's just stick it on the scales and have a look. Yeah, 127 grams. That's virtually nothing, isn't it? 127 grams. Now When it's fitted to one of the newer Panasonic bodies, such as the GH5 and the G9, it's got dual image stabilisations. You've got image stabilisation built into the lens, which I didn't know it had, but it clearly has, because when you put it on such as the G9, it comes up with a dual, where the little, you won't see it, obviously, but where the little hand is, it says dual. And that means it's using the image stabilization in the camera body and in the lens. So you get an incredible, you know, still image. Even if you've got a bit of camera shake, you're still going to get a nice sharp image. So I do like that feature. But yeah, overall, it's just a really nice compact portrait lens. Now, as far as results go, I'm again, you know, it's a cheap lens. I mean, I paid 299 quid. So it's effectively a cheap portrait lens, and you know, I got some cracking pictures with it. If you look at these, the bokeh that you get on a Micro Four Thirds won't be the same as what you get on a APS-C, and certainly not a full frame body. But that doesn't mean you can't get nice portraits. And I think it's a myth, you know, that a Micro Four Thirds isn't good for portrait work, weddings or whatever. It is. You've just got to learn the system and understand what you can do to get that nice, you know, creamy background. I mean, look at that. It's beautiful. Well, he isn't, but the background is. I mean, I'm quite close to him. I'm sat quite close to me, brother, because we just sat having a cup of tea, in a shop. And you can see there that out of focus area, it renders beautifully. So I wouldn't have a problem using this particular lens as a portrait lens. Beautiful sharpness. And you can see the eyelashes absolutely beautifully sharp. Whether YouTube actually depicts that, I don't know, with its compression. But really, really nice lens. Now, I've increased the contrast and saturation on that because I just like that. But again, you know, sharpness is phenomenal. It's sharp right across the whole range, corner to corner. You know, there's no, and that's cropped as well, because that's cropped to be panorama, that's it, that's what I'm trying to say. It's cropped as a panorama. So you can see that is really good. Now that is 1/250th of a second. It's not even that widest, f2.5. So you've got lovely sharpness corner to corner there. Again, lovely sharp image. When the computer loads it, detailing the leaves. Look at this lovely detail here. It is, you know, you've got detail everywhere here. Yeah, very pleased with that. Again, let's have a look at a tree stump. And again, the out of focus area, it renders nicely. It's really good. Plenty of sharpness there. And you can see how the, even on that picture alone, you can actually reasonably clearly see how with a wide aperture, the sharpness on the out of focus area falls off quite nicely from the focus point. So, I mean, maybe not as, well, not definitely not as good as you get with a full frame, but who would notice? If you're doing that commercially, the client would be, you know, would be happy. Again, I'm talking about the, you know, what's in focus and what's out of focus. What aperture is that? F1.7. So, you know, that tree is absolutely plenty of detail and pin sharp. And the out of focus area renders nicely. Nothing wrong with that. Can't see any issues with that at all. I would be quite happy to print that if it was a sort of image I would want to print, of course. It's only a test sample image. But again, sharpness where you want it and out of focus, you know, bokeh is where you want it. You can read that label quite clearly. No problem at all with that. And again, absolutely gorgeous sharpness in the plant's leaves. Very good. And the same there. Now that's in relatively low light. That's at 1/50th of a second at f1.7. So, you know, that's relatively low light and not an incredibly slow shutter speed by any means. But again, plenty of bokeh there. It renders it nicely. It's a nice all-round lens, you know, ideal for portrait, possibly landscapes. You want more of a wide angle for landscapes, but yeah, it does the job nicely. So, you know, could I recommend the 42.5mm lens? Absolutely, 100%. I would very much recommend it if you've got an Olympus or Panasonic camera. And as I say, you know, to throw in your kit bag, it's that small, you know, that's how tiny it is. I've got it, as I said to you earlier, it's fitted to my G9, but it'd be just as happy on my Olympus OM1. It'd work on that quite happily. So, you know, there you go. I don't think there's much else I can say about it. It does come with a lensed, nice tight fit, probably too tight, but, you know, it comes with that. And that's about it, really. There's nothing much more to say about this lens. Image stabilization on Panasonic bodies. I haven't tested it, actually, if the image stabilization works on the Olympus bodies. I suspect it probably won't. Certainly not the dual IS won't. But there we go. So that's for Panasonic 42.5mm lens. Hope you enjoyed this. Hope you found it useful. Please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already done so, if you do like my content, and hit the like button if you found this video useful. Thanks very much for watching, and stay tuned for more videos relating to video and photography. Thanks, bye.